Hi everyone, this is Patty, and I am here with our very last page. This is February, and we're going to do a flip up, a flip down, and a flip out to finish it off with. Now, there is one thing that I want to let all of you that have been following this series know. We have sold our house. We are moving back to Washington State to be near my family. And the kicker is we have to be out by the end of the month. So I am going to try desperately to do the outside cover. But if I do not get it done, I want you all to bear with me because it could be several months before I get back to crafting again because we still have to find a home there and then get settled. So I wanted you to know that there is that possibility. I will not be doing the cover for several months down the road. Like I said, I'll try to get it done before we leave, but there are no guarantees. But I did want to get the inner pages done. So what we're going to start with on our page one is you need to cut a strip that is 6 inches by 12 inches. Take a 12 by 12 sheet of paper and just cut it in half, and you'll have 6 by 12. You want to score it along what's going to be our bottom at 4 1/8. And 4 1/4, which gives us again our little gusseted piece. I took one of my tin roof caps. These are from Home Depot. These are what they use in roofing. They run about $3 for, I don't know, 50 to 100, and they're 2 3/4 inches across. Okay, this is going to be our fold up flap. Now, I took this February paper and I just cut it. This is going to be a pocket. So I put the small tape, I think this is 1/4 inch tape, along the three sides and left this side free. And I want to stretch this side so it will hold our insert. So because our book opens, and we need to have this open on the right hand side this time. So line it up evenly on your paper. It's a little off on the bottom, but I'm not going to worry about it. I want to lift it up. And make sure to burnish the three edges that have the tape and the glue on them. Okay. Now set that aside and let's do the insert. The insert is 6 1/4 by 5 1/8. And I just cut this panel out from the paper because I love the visual. This is one of the stickers. And if you don't have it, use anything. I just cut it in half. This is the back of the sticker. And then this is just a strip from the paper that I glued down on the side because your picture will go here, and I thought that was a good enhancement. On this side, you could put a picture over the top if you wanted to, or just leave it as it is. So let's glue this down. And then I'll show you what I was talking about making sure it fits in the pocket. Okay. There we go. And make sure that is glued down tight. I just went around the outside edge of this with a black Sharpie pen. You could use ink and just brush it on, or you just leave it plain, whatever you want. Okay, here's the part that we glued down, and now we want to make sure. See how nice it fits in? So what you're doing is when you put your glue on the three sides, lay whatever is going to be your insert down. Make sure that you're going to have enough room between the double-sided tape and your wet glue that your pocket, whatever your insert for your pocket, is going to slide in and out with no problem. So let's set this back. That's done. And I tell you that over and over and over again because that's something I'm not good about doing. And then I think I have it small enough and then it's not. And then it is just a bugger if you make them too big and double mat them and then they don't want to get in your pocket. Ugh. So just trying to save you some frustration. This is the inside bottom. And this is the back side of this paper. And this just goes here. And then that's going to pop up like that. And for the outside, I'm just using this from the paper. And remember, you'll have to cut this down because this is a little bit bigger. Just cut it down so that you have a nice mat underneath. And I'm not leaving pockets on these. If you wanted to have even more tuck spots, you could leave pockets, but I'll show you. Usually we insert the tag and that little tiny booklet, but I'm going to do it differently on this one. Okay, and then this goes here. Make sure you have a nice, you're lining up with this paper, the edges, and that you have a nice border across the bottom. Okay, so there's our first piece. Now we need a flip to come down from the top. And that's what this is. So you want to take another piece of paper, 6 by 6 3/4 inches, scored at 1/2 inch, fold it over. I think I'm going to trim the edges here and here just a little. I should have probably put my tape down first and then trimmed them. So do that. Put your tape down first and then trim them. This is going to go on this piece like this and pop down from the top and go underneath. So this is our flip up, this is our flip down. So in order to mat it, I took one of the pieces. This is from the 6x6 Patterns and Solids pad. And what we need is, before we glue it down here, I want to put the extra magnets that are going to go. See, this is still has to be trimmed like this. You would do better if you just use skinnier tape, and you wouldn't have this problem. There we go. Hopefully, I didn't go into. Okay, so let's go ahead and put the one side on. So take your tape off. Make sure there's none over the edge, like here. Okay, now slide it in from the top. Line it up to your crease. Okay, and lay it down. Now, we want magnets here. So what we're going to do, our magnet is here. I'm going to take, and I left this so you could see this time. I'm going to take a piece of wide double back tape. If you don't have the double back tape, use a piece of Scotch tape. Turn it upside down so that the tape, the sticky part, is up. But you have to make sure that when this flips up, there we go, it's going to catch the magnet. So put your magnets. I'm going to use two. You don't have to. I'm just going to use two. Now, you've got your tape on your magnets, and you want your magnets here. So you just lift it up. Make sure that magnets are going to, yes, fall into the black, and then just press. And now you've got your magnets in position so that when your book closes, it's going to hit the magnets. And now they're here. So now we can cover this side with our decorative paper. And I'm just going to take this little thing and make sure that it's pressed down. And I inked around the edges. I think I used one of the browns, gathered twigs, I think. Okay, so let's just glue this down. And again, like I said, I'm not making any additional pockets here. If you want pockets, you could leave a side or a top open. But because the book has gotten so bulky, I have shied away from any more layers than I have to. Line it up so it's kind of even top and bottom. Okay, like that. And now our magnets are hidden underneath there, and when it closes, it's going to magnetize. Okay, to decorate this, I took one of the stickers from the paper, one of the strips from the paper. We're going to put the strip right up here and just glue this top 1/8 to 1/4 inch across the top here. glue it down. I'll leave just a little bit of border. And the reason you only want to glue part way down is when you put your photo on this mat, you can slide it right, you can slide it right underneath there, and that mat is going to act as a stopper. Now, I still didn't like the look of this. It was just too plain to be the front part of your book. So I took the sticker. These are two stickers, and I think I'm going to put a little glue. I was trying to decide if I wanted to put a magnet here. I had this in a different spot. And this is going to go here, but we're only going to glue along this side. So again, your photo is going to slide underneath. In fact, what we could do to really keep it from is we'll just put the glue on this top part and leave this free as well. Let's do that. The other thing that I cut, and I don't know if I like them yet, but from a piece of green, I cut these two like fishtails, like this, like it looks like a little prize or something. And I thought that was kind of cute. The green just gives it a little pop. So I think I'm going to glue those on first. So let's put, this is repositional tape there. Let's just put, and this was just scraps from the paper. You could find anything or not do it at all. And we want it to go kind of like this. I thought it just kind of added that little bit of pop of green. And then we want to turn it to the right side so that you can see if you've got it about the right length and in the right place. You're centering it with this little knobby on the bottom. Turn that one just a little and pop that one in there. Oop, there we go. Okay, now, let's glue this down. I'm going to go from the first areas, and all I did was just back it with black and keep with the shape when I fussy cut it. So only go to this top curvy part. And it's going to go, in fact, you can go just below that, but not much further. And we're going to put that now so that it doesn't cross over the top, and then it's lined up straight, and we're going to glue it to that top piece that we just put on up here. There we go. That way we still are free to tuck our picture underneath, but we have this pretty accent over the top. And when you flip up now, you've got that nice visual in the front of your book, because this is what everybody will see at the beginning. So this is going to glue down, and I know it's black on black, but it's just for support. This is what glues to the back of our, to our paper that goes in the book. So we're going to hold off on that for a minute, because we want to do the side. So we're going to do the side, flip this up, flip this out. Now you're going to take a piece of black paper, and this again is a lightweight black paper, not the texture, because that way it folds nice. You're going to cut it at 7 1/4 by 6 1/4, score it on the side at 1 inch and 1 1/8 inches, and that's going to slide underneath our book this way. We're just going to center it because it's smaller now. It doesn't fit the whole way, but that alleviates a little bit of bulk at the top and the bottom so that your book will close nicely. So let's put some tape on this. And line them up on the side, making sure that you line up with the second score mark, the score mark that's closest to the right-hand side. There. And now we have our flip over to the side. I'm going to adjust my camera just a little bit so that I don't get out of frame here. So now we want a decorative mat. Well, let's go ahead and finish this top flap. And that's just a continuation of the paper, this paper here. And I'm just going to put it on the top. Oh, wait, take it back. Sorry, it's the back half. So it matches this, the flap at the bottom. So the flap at your bottom and your flap at your top are the back side of this. make sure that you have the right piece up, and let's glue this down. I think that looks cool. So now we've got this part done, and so we have our flap here to do. Let's open it up so we have just one layer to work with. So I'm going to use the cut apart. This is the one from the paper, and this is the one that comes in the extra ones with the journal. Now, if you don't have these, that's fine. Back it with whatever paper you have that you like or whatever you want to put on it. No right and wrong here. So this is going to go here. And what I did, there's a magnet here. I did it the same way because I just wanted a little extra when this is put in this way. And this is down. See, your magnet's going to be below it. And then when I flip it up, it'll catch. Just so now it's catching here and here, giving it double duty. You can put that magnet on or not, whichever you like. Okay, so let's glue this down. And this is the back of the December paper because I had left a lot of the December paper, so this worked good. So I'm going to put it in. Make sure that your outside line is straight, and then the rest of it should just fall into place. So now we have that one. This is what's going to go on the top of this, like this. So I'm going to remove my tape from burnish it down real well from my magnet. And we're going to glue this down. If you want to put a fit pull photo in here, you can cut a photo where the little girl is in, or the mother on the inside, and just place your photo inside this frame. Okay, want to make sure we get rid of the tape that's on the magnet. It may be a little wider border at the top than the bottom. I'm not going to worry about that. I don't think anyone's going to notice it. Okay, now for the back side of this, we're going to do the same thing. Another piece of that leftover green. And I have some repositional tape on here, so let me get rid of it. Okay. And we're going to glue it down. Like this. And we want to make sure that we center it in this panel. Okay. There we go. And now we're going to take this side so that we have some spot to do some journaling. And like I said, if you only have the ones, if you didn't get the journaling cards, that's fine. Use something else in this place or just leave it available for just a photo. But I love this green. I was so glad I had it left over because it just picks up. It's just that pop of color that this needs. Okay, now before we put anything else, well, I guess we could go ahead and do it. Now, we have this top and this. We have these two things that have been in every book that we, or every page we've made. Instead of making this one into the folded pocket this time, or little booklet, this one is going to go across the bottom, and it's going to be a stopper for your pictures. So I'm going to take some 1/8 inch tape, put it across the bottom here. Hope that's the bottom. Nope, that's the top. Wouldn't you know it? Okay, let's try this again. Across at the bottom, please. There we go. Get rid of that. Now I do want to put a little bead of glue on this. In fact, before I do that, let's stretch this a little bit so that we can slide our picture underneath. And we're not going to do the sides because we want to allow something wider than this to be slipped in. And then remove our tape. Got a little bit too much glue there. We'll put it on this side. And then we're going to line it up in the middle down here. Maybe I'll leave just a hint of the red under it. You can make it blush. Now I think I'll move it down so you don't have any red showing. Maybe we can do that now. There we go. Okay, now we have also the postcard. And I don't think I'm going to cut this and put ties in it. I don't know. You decide which way you like it, because what it is this is going to go up here. And I want it on, let's see, you want it where your magnets aren't. And since your magnets are here, you want to put it down here because you don't want to put any more layers over your magnets. So we're going to put it right here, and I'm going to put tape on these two sides. And again, it's going to be to create a stopper for whatever photo you put in there and just a little pretty on it. So I'm going to use the 1/8 inch score tape. Or double-sided tape, this isn't score tape, and across the bottom, I hope that's the bottom, yes, okay, and our glue, and we're going to leave just a smidgen of the red. Do I want to do that? Yeah. On the side and the bottom here. Okay, now we have a really great spot to slide our picture in. And we have some visual interest there instead of just a mat. But if you don't want that, don't put these on. Just leave them plain. Excuse me. Now, so this flips over. And this flips down. We have magnets here and magnets here to catch our. We have magnets here and magnets here to catch our tin roof cap. So when it flops up, it's all secure. And there we go. Now, wasn't that great? Gives you lots of opportunities here in a very small bundle. So now we're going to glue this down. And we can put tape all the way around because this is going to slide underneath here instead of the back this time. It will slide in this side pocket here. So let's put a bunch of tape on the back. And make sure that you've got it down. So I've got a little bit of glue I think I'll have to go back and get off. Now, again, this is the part that's going to go into our book now. So we want to really have this secure so it doesn't lift from. All right, everyone, we have it all in here. Let me zoom out now. I know you had to look at my messier desk, but now let's put our pocket in and then we can look at the whole thing here. And I put this on the bottom this tab because of where these other ones were placed. So that's something to think about before you adjust your tab and put it on. Look to see where it lines up with the other things that you've put in your book. So here's how it looks with the January. And this is the first thing people are going to see when they look in your book. And I like that. It doesn't deter from this, and you'll have pictures here. It'll just be really nice visual. So now you open it up, and you have room for a photo that will slide under here. You have room for a photo here. This goes up, and you have room for a photo to slide under the postcard. And I still haven't decided if I'm going to put thread there or not. I may. And then you have just your decorative element here. Didn't make any pockets, but you could. You could have a pocket here and a pocket here. You could actually have two. And you can put your own picture over the top of this if you want. Then it opens this way, and you have your journaling spot. And then you have a big spot for a big picture to go back here. So there is our last page done in the book. And I hope you like it. I will have a walkthrough when I've completed the outside of the whole book, start to finish. So thanks for sticking with me. And like I said, I'll try to get this finished before the move, but there is just so much to do. But I did want to get the inside completed for you. Okay, everyone, thank you so much for joining me. Have a great crafty day. Don't forget, like, subscribe, and comment. I love to hear what you're doing. Bye-bye now.